Meenakshi Kotwal, who is the district tuberculosis officer of Jammu and a very renowned doctor. She has been practicing in this field for such a long time that many people have been seeking her valuable advice during this time, especially during the time of the pandemic. And she has been actively involved as a frontline corona warrior in promoting the cause of the disease and also educating people as to how to get themselves prepared for any eventuality and also that to be taken in order to prevent such a disease. So ma'am, on behalf of Meyer College of Education, I would like to welcome you today on this guest lecture, and I would like to thank you for providing us with your valuable time and talking to our students. Is ma'am connected? I don't see her. Oh, yes, she's there.
Yes, right. She's connected.
So, ma'am, today you'll be addressing our students from the College of Education who are, training to become would-be teachers, students from the undergraduate department who are pursuing their B.Ed. and B.Ed. special education, and students from the PG department who are pursuing their MA and M.Ed. programs. So it will be a good opportunity for them to listen to you and to be educated about this particular disease, which has, caused a lot of distress in the society. And many people are scared from just moving out of their houses. So it will be a good interaction, and hope and believe that we are going to learn many new things about this particular disease and how we can prevent it from further spreading. I would also like to welcome our HODs and Deputy HODs from the PG department and the UG department and the students to this guest lecture. So not taking the time further, I'll request our convener, co-curricular committee and convener of the extension unit to kindly take the program forward, and would again like to welcome our honorable guest to today's interaction. Thank you so much.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for the formal welcome of the chief guest and the speaker of today's guest lecture. So I would like to welcome here again that our extension unit of our college is organizing this, ma'am. And here I welcome Dr. Adit Gupta, Director Meyer and Principal Meyer College of Education, Dr. Moolraj Sharma, HOD PG Department, Dr. Ronika Sharma, HOD UG Department, Deputy HODs Dr. Nishtha Rana and Dr. Monica Bajaj, faculty members and students of Meyer College of Education. As you all know that we are having an online guest lecture on the theme Precautions and Prevention of COVID-19. It gives me immense pleasure in introducing you to the learned speaker, Dr. Meenakshi Kotwal, who had made it possible today from her busy schedule to deliberate on the most pertinent theme in present time of pandemic. The theme is Precautions and Prevention of COVID-19. Dr. Meenakshi is an alumni of DBN School and thereafter completed her graduation, that is MBBS, from Government Medical College, Jammu. She has dedicatedly served in rural areas of Jammu province like Tikri, Chineni, Bhadarwa and Kishtwar. Talking about her selfless service to the society, she has been a member of a number of NGOs in these areas to help the poor and has rigorously worked towards women upliftment and girl education. Presently, Dr. Meenakshi Kotwal is working as District Tuberculosis Officer, Jammu, and looking after Jammu and Samba districts. Dr. Meenakshi and her team are tirelessly working towards their mission for elimination of tuberculosis from Jammu before 2025. As per the target given by Honorable Prime Minister Shri Narendra Modi under the slogan TB Hatega, Desh Jitega. Now I request our learned speaker and esteemed guest of this lecture to kindly say deliberate on the topic. Ma'am, please.
Very good morning to all of you. Thank you so much, Director and Principal, Mayor College of Education, Mr. Adit Gupta, and all the HODs, and in charge extension unit, and more so the future of India that you people are just making into. All the students who are undergoing their be it MA, as you said, this MA post-graduation. So yes, I'm honored that you called me for this lecture and to speak about what is happening around. We find that the pandemic is there, what pandemic it is. And most of the time now that all are learned, and I'm talking to the people, brains of society. So most of you know very much more than maybe us through the thing. But when a person who is concerned with it speaks, everybody tries to understand more than what they read through. So since I'm given a chance to speak on COVID-19, so I'll speak about the, as you said, about the preventions and precautions. But before we start to the preventions and precautions, we need to exactly know what exactly this thing is. A little bit introduction about it. So what happened? How it came? So it is just like any other viral flu. It is any other virus which causes it. But now it was dangerous. Why? Because it affected whole of the globe. And then we called it as a pandemic. It started somewhere from China. Then it came to whole of the world. Then in the month of January 2020, the WHO thought to declare it as a pandemic. And then the first case that the India saw, it was on 30th of January, and how it was concerned that it has come through some traveler or like that. So the first case in India was on 30th of January 2020, and then gradually it started moving in other states and other and whole of the India. I'm talking earlier it is pandemic, but now we will concentrate ourselves on India. Then whole of the India got involved. Then on 20th of 4th, this lockdown was there. Everybody cried, why the lockdown is there? This is a virus, why it is like that? But we need to understand why the lockdown was there and how it prevented us from going into the disastrous condition that we are today. Had it not been over there, things would have been totally different. And today also, I'll emphasize today on Jammu, that we are facing a lot of trouble, that every day we come to know that so many patients are coming, that has come out to be a community spread. But let's know about, this is like every other virus. But why it is so important, dangerous, that it is killing people. It spreads all of a sudden, and it causes a people who, it affects more the people who have less immunity. It maybe I'm also affected, but I'm not showing symptoms and signs and symptoms. Why? Because my immunity is good, but I can spread it. Even if I'm not having any sign, I'm not having any symptom, but I can spread the disease. So we need to certain know ki how, who are the people from whom we have to take ourselves away. So that comes about the symptoms. Then we call that how to recognize a person who has symptoms of COVID. So the normal symptoms, just like a normal, we have a running nose, we have a fever, breathlessness, fatigue, chills, which can sometimes be shaky also, headache, body ache, sore throat. These are the normal features that we have seen in the patients. Then we see the running nose. Then the most important, many times we find that the people say, smell nahi aa raha. We don't have a taste. So these are few things that are sometimes, somebody says, mere ko nausea ho raha hai, mere ko diarrhea ho raha hai. And we might think that person who has a running nose and the upper respiratory tract infection is the only one who is suffering. No, it can affect any part. Simple body aches. You get your test done, maybe we come out to be positive. So we don't have to overlook these things. Then we have seen that many patients are coming with the cardiac problems. Then we have the liver problems. This is all, the corona is affecting these organs. sometimes person is having a stroke. Stroke ho gaya, reason pata nahi chala. Ultimately, we got the test done. You must have heard in the news ki patient died of a cardiac arrest. But ultimately, he came out to be COVID positive. So anything that occurs is concerning to this virus. Now, what should we call, what is the thing of concern when we have a shortness of breath? Bahut zyada saans chadna shuru ho jata hai. Then we get a severe chest pains. Chest pain ekdam se hona shuru ho jaye. We feel subah uthte hain, we don't feel like puri tarah se nahi uth pate hain. And you notice there is a bluish discoloration. Our face, lips, peripheries, then it's a thing of concern. That means severity is more. Everybody is infected by maybe virus, but everybody is not showing symptoms. But some milder symptoms can be taken care of with the home rest or need not to go to hospital. But these are the things when we have shortness of breath, we have severe chest pain, we have bluish discoloration of our lips. That is a thing when doctor hospitalization is required. Now, what should we do? Once we have these simpler symptoms, we need not to panic. We need not to think that nahi ab hame hospital hi jana hai. Because in case everybody goes to hospital, then the genuinely the people who require our attention are neglected and unnecessarily a load in the hospital is created. So for before that, we need to know how many days. Suppose I got into contact with somebody and it is how many days will it take for me to have the symptoms. So it varies from 2 to 14 days. Mere andar virus gaya, but I didn't have any symptoms for a few days, but my symptoms start coming after second day to 14 day, maybe after 14 day. Ek traveler se main meet kiya ya ek COVID positive patient se maine mila mulaqat ki, but mere ko symptom nahi aaye. But they can, it is not necessarily it will come within a few hours of my contact with him. No, it might take from 2 days to 14 days. And in case I become infective, then how much time I can spread the disease to others? It is from 4th to 14th day. That is the reason we most of the time you must have seen that everybody says 14 din ka quarantine rakho ji inko. Dekho aapko agar bukhar hai to 14 din aap ghar ke andar rahe. This is what why we consider, because that is a time when we can infect. This is a time when we can have the symptoms. Even if I don't have symptom, but I can spread the COVID. Now it's again many times I am telling you that this is just like another flu. But the risk factors are there. Certain people, main healthy hu, I'm young, I'm healthy, I might not have any problem. But who are the people whom we should consider that they are the one who need more attention? We must have, in the every day you read newspapers, you must have seen person say usko ji dialysis pe rakha tha, person died. So they are the person who are more to be given attention. We say ki dama tha kisi ko saans chad rahi thi, he died of COVID. So these are certain conditions that I will enumerate are like chronic kidney disease, chronic obstructive airway disease, asthma, dama jisko hum bolte hain. Then conditions which are concerning with our heart, like coronary artery disease, koi heart failure ka patient hua hai, obesity. Then yes, there is anemia or sickle cell anemia. Those are the patients who are more prone. Diabetic patients, nowadays we find everybody is diabetic. So those are the people who need to have attention, that if they have to take full precautions, they have to have full preventive measures to avoid with the contact with the COVID patient, or they should not go into the gatherings where unknowingly they can get it. Now, and there are many, and we can now, in case we go into details, we'll be having many diseases, but we will curtail ourselves to these only. Now, how it transmits from one person to the other person. As we know, we have been saying that this virus is through droplet infection. Droplet, everybody knows about it. Maine khansa, maine chhinka. So wo jo droplets hain, in case they reach to someone else, that person inhales, he or she can also get infected by the same. These droplets can reach and stay on some object. It remains there for a time, and the time period is varies from this texture to texture. Like copper, it is 4 hours. then we say cardboard, it takes up to, it remains there for 24 hours. Viability, I mean, that is live till then. Then plastic and stainless steel from 2 to 3 days. That is why we say ki whenever we are in a room, we should frequently keep on cleaning our surroundings, our furniture, so that any fomite, any droplet, in case it is there, that is being cleaned out. So we need to know now how, what community spread is. Earlier, hum logon ne bola ki ji travelers the. Pehle we were concentrating mostly on the travelers. Ki anybody who comes from somewhere, they are to be quarantined so that they don't, in case they are having this infection, they should not spread it to others. Then gradually, we now what we are going through is a community spread, which is a dangerous one. Because whomsoever we are meeting, we are not knowing ki what status of that person. So that is a thing of concern that we should, and how to prevent ourselves from this community spread. What is community spread? Where reason is not known. Where I don't know that from whom I can get it. Because the person with I'm sitting, I know he's healthy, hale, hearty, but he might be a carrier. He might be one who can spread it. So I'm not knowing. Had I been knowing, we would have isolated that person. But since I'm not knowing from whom I'm getting it, so that comes as a community spread, which is more dangerous and which it need to be taken care. And for that, here comes the preventive and precaution. How can we prevent the community spread? Before that, it is, suppose I have all the symptoms and I feel that I have come in contact with somebody who is COVID positive, known COVID positive, or a person who has symptoms and signs of COVID. And I feel that I'm also having some symptoms like COVID. I need to get my test done. And the tests, earlier we had difficulty in finding the labs and all that. Now the government has made the tests so freely available everywhere. One is the rapid test, another is the RT-PCR test. Rapid test gives result in just 15 minutes and RT-PCR takes maybe 24 hours. It is a test is done in 2 hours only, but it, there are many processes which are taken and it takes 24 hours. So everybody should go for a test. In case the person is negative, but he or she has symptoms, even then, that person need to keep himself isolated. Now there are two words. One is isolation, another is quarantine, which everybody, many of you must be knowing ki hum bolte hain usko isolation mein rakho, usko home isolation mein rakho, usko home quarantine de do. Quarantine is what? Quarantine is when I have to keep myself away from others. I have to keep myself away from others whom I think they can have COVID or COVID symptoms. Maine apne aap ko apne ghar mein rakha, I am healthy, but I keep myself away from the people whom I think they can have symptoms. So that is a quarantine. And isolation is, I am infected, I am a patient, I keep myself isolated from others' healthy patients. I should not get in contact with the healthy patient to spread the disease. So nowadays we are putting more stress on home quarantine. What is that? Anybody who has milder symptoms, has not the severe symptoms which I explained earlier, ki jisme saans chadna hai, severe chhati mein darad hona hai, ya fainting hona hai, ya bluish discoloration hona hai, severe khansi aana hai. Agar mere ko wo cheeze nahi hai, milder body aches hai, milder headache hai, fever hai, mild, I'm talking about the minor symptoms, I should isolate myself in my home from all other people so that they don't come in contact with me. I have to keep my room away, I have to close it, I have to take my food inside only, I have to take care of my clothing, I have to take care of my utensils so that these utensils are my clothing, are myself, don't come in contact with the other people who can get that disease from me. Now, we come to the thing that you have asked me to deliver a lecture, that is prevention, how to prevent it. The most and the simplest way, wash your hands at least for 20 minutes whenever you touch something. Our frequent washing of hands with soap for 20 minutes, or you can use the sanitizers. So sanitizer, but excess of sanitizers is also causing, we have seen many patients who have got a skin reactions, skin allergies because of the sanitizers. So best is to wash your hands frequently with simple soap for 20 seconds. Then social distancing, the far most important thing the social distancing for which everybody till date has been asking us to follow. So what exactly social distancing is, how much social or physical distance we need to have. When I cough, suppose I'm a patient, I cough it out, I sneeze. So these droplets can reach up to 6 feet. So once I'm coughing, I'm sneezing, my foam, the droplet can go up to 6 feet. So that is the minimum distance everybody asks us to maintain. So it is 6 feet or 2 meters. So whenever we have to talk to each other, whenever we are in the gatherings, we should maintain this 6 feet distance to avoid it. Then we have to cover our face. We have to cover our, many times we find the people, humne mask lagaya ji, mask is over their lips only. The nose is not covered. So the most important thing is, since I touched my nose, I'll clean my hands also with the sanitizer. So basically, once we have to cover our nose, we have to cover our mouth, so that whenever, even if I cough, my droplets doesn't go anywhere. If someone else coughs, that droplet doesn't reach me. So putting on our face mask and nose mask, I mean the mask would be covering your nose and your mouth. Whenever we go, whenever we interact with anybody, we should have the mask. If we find that I put on mask and the other person doesn't, even then I can be infected, but to some percentage. But when both of us are having the mask, the chances of infection are drastically reduced. Now, what we see that many people, they want to put the mask on small kids also. So you should not put masks on children less than 2 years, people having difficulty in breathing, and unconscious patients. Because in case we put the mask on the unconscious patients, he or she is not able to take it out, that can hamper his oxygen saturation. In that case, we have to be cautious about, if we put a mask on small kids, there should be constant vigilant surveillance under us. Now, we should avoid touching our face, frequent touching of our face, that many of us invariably, knowingly, unknowingly, we keep apne face ke upar haath rakhte hain, we touch our nose, we touch our eyes. So that habit need to be prevented as much as possible. Then we have to clean and disinfect our surroundings. I'm sitting every day when I come to my office, I tell my nursing RD to clean my table with the disinfectant. In our adult places, when most of the students jo ghar mein hai, what they can do is a bleaching powder, agents they have, what they can do is that 1/3 of a cup of a bleaching agent in a bucket they can put, and they can use it for the mopping and everything. Or there is a standardized things which are provided as in the market for the cleaning and mopping, those should be used. Bleaching agent is a very good agent to utilize for our cleaning purposes. Now that these were the things which prevention and precautions we take for ourselves. Now, here comes the responsibility of all the learned people who are listening to me, that since all of you go into society and meet many people, and you all are young, healthy individuals, you have some responsibilities towards the society. And what exactly those are? In your society, if you find that there are people who are alone, they don't have anybody to look after them, it is our responsibility to meet them, to make them understand, to know about their needs. So meet a household or a larger family to talk about what their needs are like. We have to know about people of high risk in a society and their doctors, so that, God forbid, in case any of them fall sick, we can consult their doctors at time, in proper time. We should talk more often with our neighbors about emergency planning. In case in my society, in my mohalla, in my village, we have some emergency, we need to organize in a way that whenever some emergency comes, what should be our step? We have to find community aid organizations that can help with the healthcare, food delivery, and other necessities of the people. Then we need to isolate before we have to prepare ourselves. It is not that when we fall sick, then we will think of preparing a room for anybody. Anybody, we need to have a separate room in our house pre-prepared, that in case somebody falls sick, he or she should be kept in that place, and it should be done before we really get infected. Bhagwan na kare ki hum mein se koi bhi infect ho, but in case somebody gets infection, we should have a preparedness for that. What we should do, you know, I have a grown up children, I have a school going children, I'm worried about their education. I might go to the school and maybe I'm infected, and while going to the school, I infect so many people. So government and everybody, like all you, the educational organizations have taken a very good step that they have started the online classes. This is a very good step that where we can prevent the gatherings. Now, talk to the families more often. You know, what happening is in the isolation, we are there. We are all absorbed in the social networking and the news. Sometimes the news is also causing us trouble. Aise hota hai, waise hota, which is all wrong. This is the time when we can involve ourselves to talk to our relations. We can build those relations which we have lost in the past. So talk to your relations, ask them about their welfare, whether they need help, because many of the people must be ignorant about so many things. So we can make them aware that what are the things which precautions and prevention they need to take. In case they need your help, you should be there to help them. Then we have to do certain things. As a social worker also, we have to make certain efforts to make everybody aware about these things in our surroundings. This is for the youngsters that who must be watching me, because they are all healthy and they can be helpful to the people who really need them. So then sometimes, many times people ask us, are the masks beneficial? Yes, the masks are definitely beneficial, because they prevent the spread of virus from me to others and their virus from coming to me. Now, that's the I just talked about to you about the quarantine and the isolation. Then we and every day we listen that the vaccine is coming. So there are vaccines might come, but it might take time. The only way at present to prevent ourselves from corona, COVID-19, is to wear masks, social distancing, avoid gatherings, and frequent washing of hands and face with soap and water or sanitizer. As far as gatherings are concerned, those should be avoided till we get a stage where there is no spread. At present, all the gatherings should be avoided as much as possible. Treatment part, when we talk about treatment, we don't have any treatment till date for coronavirus. Whatever treatment is being given is symptomatic. Many people, since it is a virus, we have seen कोई दाखल हो जाता अस्पताल में उसको जी सबसे बड़ा एंटीबायोटिक दे दिया उसको ये दे दिया उसको अपने अपने सारे नुस्खे लेके आ रहे हैं काढ़ा पियो जी आप वो खाओ जी एक वन समबडी कम्स विद द ये लेके आया दूसरा तुलसी का लेके आया तीसरा कोरोनिल लेके आया सो वी आर गोइंग थ्रू सो मच क्योर्स सो इट इज बेटर टू कीप अवर सेल्फ आवर माइंड फ्री फ्रॉम ऑल वी हैव टू डेवलप हेल्दी हैबिट्स We have to keep take full prevention and precautions of putting on the mask, social distancing. In case we take healthy diet, we take plenty of fluids, we take fresh fruits. We will not require anything else. But taking all these kind of things is making us what? Many of the patients, इतने ज़्यादा उन्होंने काढ़े पी लिए हुए हैं कि अब उनको जॉन्डिस हो गया हुआ है. इतना ज़्यादा उन्होंने बोल लिया उनको गैस्ट्राइटिस हो गया हुआ है. So we have to be prevention. Unless your doctor prescribes you. Don't take anything. As we told you, milder symptoms, it will come, it will go. It depends upon your immunity. Stay positive. Throughout, stay positive. This is not going to kill us unless we invite them to kill us. So we have to have a positive attitude. We have to follow the preventions and precautions. We have to wash our face and our hands frequently with water and soap. We need not to have sanitizers. We can use the soap and water also. And then अफवाहों से बचे. दैट इज द मोस्ट प्रिवेंट थिंग विच वी कैन. डोंट गो टू यस इन केस आई हैव सम सिम्टम्स आई शुड मीट माई डॉक्टर. वट एवर माई डॉक्टर सेज यस माई एंटीबायोटिक्स आर गिवन पेन किलर्स आई मीन द एंटीवायरल एंटीबैक्टीरियल एंटीपायरेटिक फीवर के लिए सब कुछ दे रहे हैं बट इट इज सिम्टोमेटिक ट्रीटमेंट इज गिवन. I have a viral high load, they will give me antivirals. I have a secondary infection with bacteria, they will give me bactericidal if these medicines. I have fever. So simple is fever above 100, take paracetamol, hydrate yourself, keep yourself happy, keep your thing good, nothing wrong will happen to you. But in case we take to keep on taking all these kind of cocktails, मुझे आयुर्वेदिक भी खानी है, मुझे एलियोपैथिक भी खानी है, मुझे यूनानी भी खानी है, मुझे हर कोई मेडिसिन खाना है, तो वी आर इन ट्रबल. वी वोंट कम आउट ऑफ इट वेरी इजीली. सो द ओनली माइट कम रिसर्चेस आर गोइंग ऑन दिस बट सिंस दिस इज अ न्यू वायरस इट विल टेक सम टाइम फॉर द मेडिसिन टू कम. वी हैव सीन अबाउट व्हाट द चाइनीज बिकॉज चाइना वॉज टू फर्स्ट टू हैव इट. There, the recovery rate was up to 97% to 99%. It was the recovery rate. We will also have, we too have very good. In India, we are having between 83% to 87% of the recovery rate. Recovery rate is very good. Yes, we have mortality. Mortality means the death rate is only seen mostly with the comorbidities. It is seen with the patients who have kidney diseases, who have heart diseases, who have lung diseases. They are the mostly the people who have died because of corona. Otherwise, most of the people have come up. Now, another thing which comes in the mind, can I again be infected with the corona? It depends on my immunity. You know, when I get infected by a viral, antibodies are produced in my body and they remain for 3 to 4 months normally. I'm talking about the coronavirus. And after that depends on my immunity. If I'm immunocompromised, I'm not well, I might again be infected. But till now, we have not seen a reinfection because this is just that we are going through the first peak of things. Now, these were very few things which I think most of you already must be knowing. But you wanted it through a doctor only. So I came and I talked to you. So my only advice to all the youngsters who are listening to me, that be good citizen of India. Come forward to help those who don't have anybody to look after them. All of you are youngsters. You have your good immunity. I won't ask the people who have comorbidities, but all other youngsters who are healthy, they should educate your surrounding. It is not necessary to gather people and educate. You have many means to educate your surroundings. Tell everybody to maintain a social distancing, to put on the mask, wash their hands frequently with soap and water, and be positive to remain healthy. This is what I had to speak. But yes, since I am working as a district tuberculosis officer, I would like to speak few words on tuberculosis also. So corona, everybody so apprehensive. कोरोना से ये हुआ, कोरोना से वो हुआ, इतने मर गए, वो मर गए. Nobody had ever even thought that every day about 1,100 to 1,400 people in India die of tuberculosis. In world, every year we encounter about 3 lakh to 4 lakh people dying of tuberculosis. Why we don't talk about it? Because this is a disease which most of the times happens to be a disease of poor. I'm a good kind of person. I have a say. I get infected by corona, I will make hue and cry. I will speak about it. But once I'm dying, I see in the person dying in jhugi because of tuberculosis, I don't take that chance. I forget that sometime I might also be infected by tuberculosis. So we have to work on that also. But not today, since it is today you have asked me to speak on corona. I am talking about that. But yes, I would like to come to your institution once this COVID era is over to speak on this, because I need the young people. A teacher is the best person whom we can contact and who can bring a major change in the society. Thank you so much.
Thank you, ma'am, for your very, very informative deliberation. And ma'am, I would like to ask you a query which has been asked by a student.
Komal ma'am, just before you take on the questions, because I had to go for another meeting, I'll like
okay,
to personally
sir.
Thank Dr. ma'am for
thank
an excellent
so
discourse. Obviously, as you said, that information was available in the open domain, but listening from you was quite reassuring, and everybody, you know, came to know that it is not as dangerous as we make it out to be, and just by a little precaution, we can, you know, overcome this disease. In fact, some of our faculty members have already gone through this.
They are all healthy, naughty.
You know, they have come out fighting healthy.
They are the fighters.
Few people in my family have also undergone this disease. So we are just trying to take precautions and prevent measures.
Yeah, sure. That's the only thing.
Most of the people, as you said, will not even know that COVID had hit them and it has just passed away. And they will develop, hopefully, some immunity against the disease. But thank you so much for your time. And we hope that in future also we'll be connecting with you on many more issues and seeking your guidance for our students.
Thank you so much.
So I'll request Komal ma'am and Sumal ma'am to kindly continue and ask the questions which the students have been asking.
Thank you,
okay,
sir.
Thank you, sir. And all the best. All the best also.
Yes.
I would like to add a simple thing. My husband, 1977, batch of your school. He was a topper. He topped that time in 10th. First position he got from their school. He was fourth in the three. The first three girls were from presentation convent, but he was the first from model. That time it used to be Model Academy. So he's a physician. He is now a physician. He just retired in the month of July. So I just wanted to add it to your knowledge because you do have produced very good doctors. And
so, ma'am, what is his name?
He is Dr. That time he was Rajiv Kotwal. Now he is Dr. Rajiv Kotwal. So he's a physician and he's did his two post graduations. One he did in medicine and other he did in radio diagnosis. So he is alumni of your school. I just wanted to add it on there. More so reason
I have
to
noted
edit
it down. So we'll get in touch with him maybe for some alumni interaction also.
Sure. Thank you so much. Thank you. God bless you all.
Thank you, sir. Ma'am, I want to ask you some queries regarding this lecture. The students have put in. Ma'am, they say that what type of food items should be avoided during COVID-19?
See, you don't have to avoid anything. You eat whatever you feel like, but yes, in case you have nausea, vomiting, that kind of features, you have to avoid the fried food. You need to indulge into healthy food. Simple ghar ka dal chawal khaoge, you will be all fine. It is all myth. Don't take this, don't take that. You can have everything you feel like, but yes, avoid junk food. But since all for them to whom I'm interacting are mature enough to understand junk food at this juncture of time is not advisable because it invites them. Food made in the house is the best to have. Don't take outside food or the food which you are not knowing from where you are bringing it. So it should be the homemade food and whatever you feel like you should take. You should keep yourself hydrated. Take as much as food you can. So hydration is very important aspect. Take fruits, take protein-rich diet because that helps to build your immunity. You should take dals as much as possible because dals are the protein-rich food. Whatever you feel like, don't take junk food. Avoid fried, too much fried. In some case, somebody is hypertensive, they need to avoid they should restrict the salt and rest. There is no restriction for food ki ye nahi khana wo nahi khana. They can have whatever they feel like. Jo normal routine mein they take food, they should take it.
Thank you, ma'am. Query that what if the COVID patient comes in contact with pet animal like dogs, cows, and cats?
I forgot to tell you. You know, we cannot get infection from animal. But yes, we are the culprits. We can infect them. So from animals, we cannot get infection, but from us, they can get the infection. But in case the droplets are on them and we touch them, and then we touch our face, our nose, from their skin, it can come to them. But in case an animal is infected by coronavirus and he coughs or sneezes, so his droplets don't infect the humans. But human droplets, they can infect the animals. They can infect the humans. But yes, in case if the droplets on their skin are on their fur, that can reach us. But not the sneezing or infected animal cannot infect us.
Okay, ma'am. One more question. Can someone test negative and later test positive for COVID-19? Do we need frequent testing then?
No. You know, see, what I tell you is rapid test, as I said, and I told you about the RT-PCR. As long as the virus is within us, the test will remain positive. But the infectivity reduces. Maybe I am positive, but I am not infective. As I told you, infectivity is from 4th to 14th day is the infective period. I get infected. I started symptoms on the second day. I can have symptoms up to 14 days. But I can infect others despite having or not having symptoms from 4th to 14th day. Even if after 14th day, I'm COVID positive, but I cannot spread the infection. As I said, ki rat test, hum abhi rapid test karwa rahe hain. Usme positive means positive, but negative doesn't mean that he is not negative. For that, we need to go for RT-PCR. RT-PCR, once is positive, that means ki we have an infection, but it can be non-infective period also, it can come out to be positive. So nowadays, every SOPs are changing. The SOP is changing that in case I have been detected COVID positive, after 10 days, normally they used to get the another test to find out negative aaya ya nahi aaya. So it is not required, because then we consider that the patient is non-infective. So it is not necessarily that the patient can be infective after covering that infective period from 4th through 14th. I think it's unclear. I should repeat.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you
so much, ma'am. A misconception or a query that the people have, and one student is again asking regarding that. If a person from the family gets corona positive and then he is recovered, so do we need to maintain a distance from that person?
But in case he is all fine, mere ko zukam ho gaya, zukam theek ho gaya, so it's not required. This is what I said na, 4th through 14th day, if the person has fully recovered, so he cannot spread it. Okay. So it is quite obvious. That is the reason we keep a person in isolation for 14 days. After 14 days, we don't say ki aap, even if the person has recovered, even if I am not a COVID patient, even if someone else is, we have to maintain a distance. That has to be there. If somebody is infected or not infected, we have to maintain a distance till the time we feel that we have got rid of this infection. In case we don't follow, maybe that recovered patient gets an infection from some other person who feels that I am fine. Maybe he is a carrier. So distancing is very important for everybody to maintain, and putting on your mask is the far most important thing. If somebody is a COVID positive and I stay in contact with that person, so I am with the mask, I don't have to worry much, because chances of my getting infection are less.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you so much, ma'am. You have very, very elaborately explained all the queries related to this coronavirus and the COVID-19 pandemic. Now I would request Mrs. Suman Devi, who is the in charge of extension unit, to kindly say a formal vote of thanks.
Thank you, Komal ma'am. I, Suman Devi, in charge extension unit, on behalf of my College of Education, I deem it my proud privilege to propose a formal vote of thanks. I am extremely thankful to Dr. Meenakshi Kotwal, District Tuberculosis Officer, Jammu, for sparing her valuable time and acquainting us about novel coronavirus. Thank you, ma'am. I extend my gratitude to our worthy principal, Dr. Adit Gupta, for providing us great strength and moral support. Thank you, sir. I would like to express my sincere thanks to Dr. Moolraj Sharma, Head PG Department, and Dr. Ronika Sharma, Head UG Department, for their guidance and support for making the program. Thank you, sir. Thank you, ma'am. I would like to acknowledge the contribution of Dr. Nishtha Rana, Deputy Head PG Department, and Dr. Monica Bajaj, Deputy Head UG Department, for their support in the program. Thank you, ma'am. My special thanks goes to our convener and co-convener co-curricular committee, Mrs. Komal Sharma and Mrs. Ruchika Kapoor, for their continuous help in the program. Thank you, ma'am. I am also thankful to the faculty members and students of the college for participating in the program. Thank you all once again. Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, ma'am.
For sparing your valuable time and enlightening us regarding this very pertinent topic that is going on now. Thank you so much for being our guest.
Thank you. Thank you so much. But I would like to have the feedback from the students whether this has helped them or not, because that will be really, I will be thankful to you all for calling me over here, and my delivery of the lecture will be fruitful only when I get the feedback. Thank you. Thank you so much.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you.
God bless you all.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
Komal ma'am, Komal ma'am, am I audible?
Hanji, 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 ma'am. Ma'am, wo thoda change kar rahi thi for layout.
कोमल मैम ये कह रही थी कि एक तो रिकॉर्डिंग कर लो आप ऑफ, दूसरा ये था कि ये था आपका जो स्टूडेंट्स का स्टेटस है अटेंडेंस का, इट वाज वेरी लो, तो वी नीड टू टेल टू द स्टूडेंट्स दोज हु हैव नॉट जॉइन्ड, राइट, द वंस यू जनरेट